I lived in Hong Kong for 6 months as part of a student exchange. And whilst I was there, Hong Kong Disneyland became a home away from home. Whilst it's not the largest or the best Disney theme park in the world, this charming park situated on Lantau Island has a lot to offer. Just 10 minutes drive from Hong Kong Airport, or a relatively short trip on the Hong Kong MTR, you'll find yourself immersed in a Disney resort like no other. A quick note before we start is that we visited before a majority of new construction started to turn the park into what we've dubbed Hong Kong Disneyland 2.0, featuring a new castle and land. So some elements of this review are likely to be different over time. I'm Dominic, and this is ReviewTyme's review of Hong Kong Disneyland. Family rides, 10 out of 10. It's a Disney theme park. Anything other than a 10 would be outrageous. Hong Kong Disneyland offers a huge range of attractions for the family. From a classic Winnie the Pooh track dark ride to a modern trackless tour through Mystic Manor, this park has everything. Whilst this section is called Family Rides, there are several other non-ride-based attractions as well that the family can enjoy. This includes Tarzan's Treehouse, which retells the story of Tarzan, with some spectacular views of the park, and Fairy Tale Forest, which will take you through the many princess stories with mini dioramas of beloved scenes from Disney movies. The highlight of the park is Mystic Manor, an amazing dark ride through the manor of Lord Henry Mystic, who gathers exotic artifacts from around the world. Being inspired by the classic Haunted Mansion attractions, the manor starts to come alive when a mysterious music box is opened. The effects, trackless ride system, theming, story, and pacing make this one of the best Disney attractions in the world, and many will argue the same opinion. Many people even say that a trip to Hong Kong Disneyland is worth it alone for this attraction. As is the norm with most Disney parks around the world, even relatively small children are able to ride the more adult attractions, which opens up even more opportunity for family fun. Thrill rides, 6 out of 10. Hong Kong Disneyland has a similar lineup of thrill rides to what you'd expect to find in any Magic Kingdom-style park, with some unique additions. Space Mountain makes a return in this park, and whilst the thematic elements and queue are watered down compared to the others around the world, the ride itself is still excellent. However, as of my last visit, the theming has been adjusted to Hyperspace Mountain, a Star Wars version of the attraction. The additional elements are pretty neat. The classical version and soundtrack will always be my favorite. Also, in Tomorrowland is the newest attraction to their lineup, Iron Man Experience, an enclosed simulator experience similar to Star Tours around the world. Whilst it doesn't offer anything groundbreaking, it's still a solid attraction and is a great addition to the Hong Kong Disneyland lineup. Also, getting to see yourself fly out of Disneyland at the start of the attraction is a fun little touch. The best thrills in the park, however, come from Big Grizzly Mountain Runaway Mine Cars, a spectacular roller coaster which is a great mix of the classic Big Thunder Mountains and Expedition Everest in Animal Kingdom. This roller coaster features several unexpected thrilling elements, which I don't want to spoil because they are part of the fun. The low-lying, twisted nature of the track layout also helps to reinforce the idea that these mine cars are definitely running away. The small lineup is enough to give thrill seekers a quick fix, especially within a Magic Kingdom-style Disney park. Experiences, 9 out of 10. Part of the appeal of a Disney resort is being able to constantly find different happenings around the park, and Hong Kong Disneyland offers a lot in terms of experiences. Some examples of these experiences are turning around the corner in Main Street. I would often find Sunny, a cast member, playing songs on a mobile bicycle piano. In Tomorrowland, you would often encounter the Jammeters playing different beats with their janitorial equipment. Whilst we were there, we also experienced a temporary attraction themed to Marvel superheroes. This attraction saw us literally running through corridors trying to escape from Hydra. It was a great experience, and we constantly found ourselves moving through the impressive scenery saying, "Damn, this is temporary." This falls into an extensive history of next level temporary attractions, as when I previously visited the park, there was a Halloween scare maze called the Nightmare Experiment, which was incredible. Now this is possibly the easiest park to meet characters due to the lesser crowd numbers. In other parks, I've found that to meet Mickey or the gang, it'd often require at least an hour out of your day. However, when I visited Hong Kong Disneyland, it would only take about 10 minutes to meet them. Characters do roam around the park occasionally as well. I've seen Merlin, Alice, and some wandering pirates in Adventureland. Entertainment. 9 out of 10. Hong Kong Disneyland features some of the best entertainment that Disney has to offer. When we visited, the shows and parades on offer were the Festival of the Lion King, Mickey and the Wondrous Book, the Flights of Fantasy Parade, and Paint the Night, as well as Disney and the Stars, the nighttime fireworks spectacular. The two stage shows both feature live singing and dancing, which is unfortunately becoming rarer in theme park shows. Both shows are incredibly satisfying and will keep you entertained whilst you have a well-deserved break from the park. Hong Kong Disneyland features two parades. Flights of Fantasy is the park's daytime parade and is lively, uplifting, and just all-around good fun. The fly-in theme means that many of the floats are incredibly large and tall. Paint the Night, the evening parade, is easily one of my favorite Disney parades. And because Hong Kong Disneyland doesn't get the traffic of the other parks, you can almost always get a front row seat. We managed to snag a perfect spot right at the start of the parade route, only about 10 minutes before the show began. To finish the day, we experienced Disney in the Stars, Hong Kong Disneyland's nighttime fireworks spectacular. Whilst it's the same show that opened with the park in 2005, they've recently added projection mapping to the castle to make it even more lively. However, as of early 2018, this show has been retired and will ultimately be replaced after the construction of the new castle is complete. Staff, 9 out of 10. I think it should be immediately praised that staff members at Hong Kong Disneyland are required to speak conversational Cantonese, Mandarin, and English. In my many visits to the park, I always found the staff to be caring and attentive. Pin trading isn't huge over there, but it is available and rare pins do circulate through the park. The staff that I came across got very excited when you approached them with a large lanyard full of pins, so make sure to wear your collection. In terms of operations, the rides and shows always ran very smoothly. In the 6 months I visited the park, averaging about 2 visits a week, I never experienced a single breakdown or operational problem. The staff are also great at managing the crowds and looking out for their safety during events like fireworks and parades. Also, a shout out to Sonny, the roaming piano player. I would always hang around to watch his shows as he provided great atmosphere with a smile. He would often remember who I was, ask about my day, and what I've been up to. He had a genuine joy about his work, and I think that is incredibly commendable. Theming, 7 out of 10. Being a classic Magic Kingdom style Disney park, all of the expected themed areas are here: Main Street USA, Tomorrowland, Fantasyland, and Adventureland. The lands set the mood and setting, but don't have the all-encompassing feeling that other international Disney parks have. This is due to early budget constraints when the park first opened, and they're still trying to fix the mistakes that were made in the original construction of the park. A prime example of this is being able to see Space Mountain from Fantasyland. If you're interested in learning more about the history of Hong Kong Disneyland, we have a video exploring that very topic, which can be reached in the icon above. However, the later additions, such as Big Grizzly Mountain and Mystic Manor, are incredible in terms of theming, attention to detail, and scale, and are truly world-class when it comes to their theming. The park has also made good use of the natural tropical climate in Hong Kong, with Adventureland looking the most wild and untamed around the world thanks to the large amounts of tropical foliage. Merchandise, 9 out of 10. It may be the cutesy or perhaps practical nature of the merchandise at Hong Kong Disneyland that really appeals to me, but I've found that it's very easy and affordable to find some great gifts and take-homes. Whilst it may be a little pricey for some items depending on where you come from, overall we found the merchandise to be well-priced. Affordability, 8 out of 10. As Australians, the Hong Kong Disneyland Resort is probably one of the cheapest resorts to visit, just after Tokyo. The price of admission for 2 days at this point is around $95. While some people may argue that the park can be completed in a full day, if you want to fit it all in terms of shows and get a satisfying amount of rides and the attractions, we recommend visiting for 2 days. Food and drinks within the park are what you'd expect from a Disney park. For around $13, you can get a complete meal with a drink and sides. I highly recommend whilst visiting to try the caramel popcorn, which is amazing and you can smell it absolutely everywhere. This isn't a meal. You could probably make it a meal though, because it's just so damn delicious. Because of the relatively close distance to the city of Hong Kong, accommodation slightly off property is always within the affordable price range. For the all-encompassing experience, you can stay on property, but the park doesn't offer nearly as many benefits from staying in the hotels as other resorts. However, this doesn't mean that the resorts aren't amazing, because I've visited all of them and they're spectacularly themed, comfortable, and relaxing. Atmosphere, 9 out of 10. The park is surrounded by mountains that can be seen from most areas of the resort. Where there are not mountains, there is ocean, and the park is far away from any built-up areas of Hong Kong City. This creates a unique sense of isolation and immersion, which is unparalleled to any other Disney park in the world. It allows you to truly get into the experience, even if the mountains did dwarf the old castle, probably part of the reasons why they're currently fixing it up. The tropical nature of Hong Kong means that the park is also incredibly lush. There is greenery surrounding many areas of the park, and it feels very natural, almost like walking through a nature reserve in some parts. It's a parallel to the early Magic Kingdom style parks, which were mostly concrete pathways. Because the locals are used to fascinating nighttime lights in the neon jungle of Hong Kong, they stepped up their game with the lighting of the park at night, and it is absolutely gorgeous. Services, 9 out of 10. With cast members speaking Cantonese, Mandarin, and English, you shouldn't have any problems with communications around the park. This park was designed with international travelers in mind, so signage, maps, and menus were never a problem. I visited guest relations quite often to give compliments to cast members that went above and beyond. The people working in guest relations were always fantastic to deal with, and were often excited that I was giving compliments, as I would imagine that they'd probably need to deal with a lot of negativity in that role. Around the park, bins were of ample supply. There was always somewhere to grab something to eat or drink, and the toilets were well upkept. And, on the rare occasion that I needed to visit first aid, they were wonderful to deal with. The resort also features services which makes traveling a breeze, such as a check-in service nearby the park entrance, a merchandise holding system which allows you to send your new goodies to the front gate so you can collect it on your way home, and you can also get your merchandise delivered to your room if you're staying on property. Final thoughts. Hong Kong Disneyland is a perfect first Disney park for someone or a family who aren't sure if they really like Disney or not. The park features all of the amazing things Disney is known for, without the crazy crowds and wait times every other resort gets. This park is also poised to get even better over the next few years, with each year featuring a new, large addition to the park, including a new castle, a new Frozen Land, and a new Avengers attraction, all coming within the next few years. Also, it's the only place in the world you can experience Mystic Manor. In our eyes, that alone makes it worth the trip. Hong Kong Disneyland gets review time score of 85 out of 100. I'm Dominic, and this is Review Time.